Welcome to Arrowhead Stadium for the 2000 Big 12 Championship between the Oklahoma Sooners and the Kansas State Wildcats. Let's go to the field where the Sooners are set to kick right here on ESPN Classic.
Tim Duncan's got it teed up as Oklahoma won the toss and deferred, and back deep for Kansas State, Aaron Lockett, and he can, as Swanee said, make a big play in a hurry. This one's going to bounce to the 8-yard line of Terrence Newman, and Newman comes near side, found a little bit of room and got out with a flag flying in to about the 28-yard line, and we may have an illegal block on the opening kickoff. Our referee's Randy Crystal. Not the way that Kansas State wanted to start things off.
And you hope this is not a sign of things to come.
Right. It's a holding call. And for Kansas State this year, the second most penalized team in school history. Jonathan Beasley will bring him out. There's his numbers, an even 50%. 16 passing touchdowns and tied with his teammate, Josh Scobie, for the Big 12 lead in rushing touchdowns, also with 16. Bobby's not a polished passer, but he gets the job done pretty well.
He's versatile. He gets around, and not a very accurate passer. He goes for the big plays, averaging 17 and a half yards per completion.
So they'll have to work with a penalty from their own 14-yard line. They shift into an eye backfield with Scobie the tail from the 14, and he'll get the call. Got two, maybe three. Ran right into Ryan Fisher. Let's take a look at the Dr. Pepper starting lineups. Up front, the big eaters for Kansas State. Stevenson, E.B. Cummins is an all-Big 12 performer. Robertson and Barnett. Scobie the tailback with Rock Cartwright, his lead man. Myers the tight end, and Morgan and Lockett can change a game in the blink of an eye. Second down and seven. Just underway in a noisy Arrowhead Stadium. And there's Quincy Morgan. On the ground, a Cartwright. And The Rock got it out to about the 24-yard line. He might have gotten a first down with that last little push. Defensively for Oklahoma, Heinicke, Fisher, all-conference, Holliman and Callens. The linebacking core is about as good as it comes. Stephen Marshall, who saved some games, and Rocky Kalmus, who's a Butkus finalist. And the secondary looks like this. Thompson, Thatcher with 8 interceptions. Williams might be the best strong safety in the league, and Derek Strait as well back there in the back four. And that's JT Thatcher. 8 interceptions on the season, ties a school record.
The big play written all over Thatcher.
Boy, does he ever. But Cartwright, his extra effort got him a first down just inside the 25-yard line. Play action. Beasley wants it all. Going long. We're going to have an incompletion and no penalty marker. Aaron Lockett's looking all over the field as Michael Thompson was with him stride for stride. They incidentally got their feet tangled up, apparently. No penalty marker.
Third play of the game. Play action. Lockett goes deep. Little shove there by Thompson, 19. And the ball was in the air, so it could have been called, but early in the ball game, I think they're going to let him play a little bit.
So it brings up second down and 10.
Lockett is not very big. He's only 5'7 and 165, yeah. So any little push and he's going down.
And that's with marbles in his pockets. Not very big. David Allen splits out as a third wide out of the backfield. And here's a quarterback draw on Beasley. And Beasley banging his way for some positive yardage. The ball is loose. Oklahoma says they've got it. They do. And the Sooner fans on their feet for Roy Williams.
Well, the Sooners were going after the ball. He's a right-handed quarterback carrying it in his left hand. That's Marshall, I think, that pulled it out. There it is on the ground. Nobody knows it's out. Marshall knows it's out.
And Rocky Kalmus pointing in the Sooners' direction.
32 takeaways for the defense on the year. That's almost three a game for the Sooners.
See if Oklahoma can take advantage of the turnover. They might try to do it on one play. Heupel play action goes down. Towns got him inside the five. Andre Wolfolk, and it's first and goal, Oklahoma.
Wolfolk, the wide receiver, goes to the post immediately. Single coverage out here. Nobody in the middle of the field. See, there's nobody down here in the middle. Could have thrown the ball more to the inside. It may have been a touchdown if he'd led him across the field.
23-yard pickup, and it's first and goal. Griffin dives maybe to the two.
Griffin, the ball carrier.
Josh Heupel, who threw a strike on his first pass, 18 touchdowns, almost 3,200 yards, and the Big 12 Offensive Player of the Year.
Hasn't lost a game this year. I mean, when you stop to think where Oklahoma started, they started at 20th in the nation, and moved him up, beat the number one team, Nebraska, Kansas State number two, all on his shoulders.
Griffin, 16 rushing touchdowns on the year. They're showing blitz. And whistles will halt play here as Heupel started to roll out with it.
Well, anytime you see those guys up there, and then one of the offensive linemen will normally budge a little bit when they see the linebacker inside blitzing.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense.
False start, Oklahoma.
5-yard penalty and remains second down.
5 Stoops, his team with an opportunity here after the fumble recovery to take the early advantage. But now they're backed up outside the 5-yard line at second and goal at the 7. 3 wideouts will trot out to the near side. And Trent Smith, the tight end, up to the top of your screen. Heupel from the gun. The quick throw to his tight end. He caught it on the second try. He's got it at the 1-yard line.
Trent Smith is a tight end, but he's 6'5 and 227. They almost treat him like a tall wide receiver. They split him out to the wide side, almost like a wide receiver would be, and they throw the slant to him. Knocks it down, and then he gets a fortunate bounce. It's on the 1-yard line.
He caught it twice. Seth Luttrell, the fullback, is a single setback. Third and goal at the 1. It's Heupel trying to do it himself.
He didn't get it the first time.
They're still unpiling bodies and no word from the officials. He didn't get in. It's fourth and goal.
I think this is a situation where you're going to go for it. You got a break on the turnover. You're down on the 1-yard line. Even if you don't make it, you leave them on the 1-yard line.
Exactly. You leave them 99 and a half away. Quentin Griffin trots back in. He's not the biggest back in the world, but he can smell the end zone. He's done it 16 times this year.
And he scored 6 times earlier this year in 1 game against Texas.
They'll spread him out. Shotgun. Fourth and goal. Griffin didn't get there. Fatafehi's got him. Big goal line stand for Kansas State.
Huge.
Griffin on a quick opening draw to the shotgun, couldn't get there.
Phil Bennett, the defensive coordinator, blitzes Kazar, number 54. That disrupts the timing and allows the other Wildcats to get there.
What a big stop. Kansas State on offense when we come back. Josh Heupel threw 2 strikes on that drive, but they come up short on fourth and goal. Bob Stoops made the decision to go for the touchdown. They were inside the 1, and Kansas State came up with a huge goal line stand. So now they take over the shadow of their own goalpost, and Scobie is leveled by Roy Williams. Let's go back to that goal line stand, Bob.
Yeah, great play by Kansas State. A blitz. Kazar, the linebacker right here, is going to shoot into the gap. Fatafehi right here, the defensive tackle. Watch these two guys play. Kazar disrupts it. Fatafehi, 75, gets around his man. And Yates, number 12, gets in there and no chance. What you need in that situation is a big fullback leading your tailback.
There's part of the emotional inspiration on that defense. Fatafehi has made some big plays all year long. Here's a quick throw out to Morgan. And Morgan knee touched.
Yeah, it was a low throw, and he had to go down to make sure he caught it, and the knee was on the ground.
Quincy Morgan, that's his 101st career catch. And he's got the single season receiving record over 1,100 yards. Closing in on Kevin Lockett's touchdown mark. And, of course, Kevin's little brother, Aaron, already playing in this game and has made a catch. It's a third down and 7. And there's Lockett.
For Kansas State, you got to be careful throwing the ball from down in this area.
Here comes a blitz. Beasley's in trouble. Got rid of it. Batted in the air. Nobody could get there. Torrence Marshall, the linebacker, got his hand on it.
Torrence Marshall has made himself huge in this game already. Only 2 defensive possessions. Once he stripped the ball loose and caused the fumble. Secondly, now he's on a blitz, times his jump properly, and knocks the ball away.
Not a nice spot to have to punt from either. You got to have a perfect snap. And JT Thatcher waits at midfield.
Normally you want 14 yards for your punter.
They're stretching that limit right now. Snaps clean.
Return, no block.
High kick, but short, very short. Thatcher will take the fair catch at the 38-yard line. So again, great field position for Oklahoma after just a 33-yard punt. First quarter, the starting field position's been all Oklahoma. Second possession for them. They work from the 38. Heupel going deep. Man's out there, just overshot Woolfolk, who we hooked up with for 23 yards on the first series. Let's check our Dr. Pepper starting lineups. Here's the Biggins up front. Romero, Duncan, Burcham, and all Big 12 performers, Skinner and Kempenick. Savage and Fagan, Woolfolk and Norman, the 4 wideouts that'll be rotated, and Quentin Griffin, the starting tailback. And Quentin Griffin can catch the ball, too.
He's a tailback with 38 catches on the year.
And he's got exactly the same amount of yardage as Scobie for Kansas State. Here comes the blitz. They'll try it again. Same play. Incomplete. Nice coverage. Dyshod Carter stayed right there.
Now, Kansas State very fortunate there. A blitz on, single coverage down there. Carter didn't see it. Woolfolk did, but he didn't come down with it.
I think if Josh gets a little more on that pass, it might be a touchdown, Bob. He underthrew him a little bit.
He did, and he saw it. Carter did not see it, but did a nice job of breaking it up. He said he's coming back for something. Now he looks back late. Good job by the defender.
Josh has thrown 4 passes, 3 toward Woolfolk. They're showing blitz again. Let's see if they bring it on 3rd and 10. Now the tight end Smith comes in tighter for some protection.
There's the linebackers up there. There
they come. Heupel, plenty of time. Fires complete. Inside the 25, and it's Damian Mackey. And it's a first down, Oklahoma. When you got that kind of time with that kind of heat coming, Greece, has got to be somebody open.
Well, you know, they did a little blitz, but it was a zone blitz. They dropped a lot of guys back. He didn't have the center of the field open. It's a nice wrinkle by Kansas State, but give Heupel credit. He found the open guy.
Comes up with a big pass play on 3rd and 10, and that's first down at the 24.
Kansas State has had 2 weeks to prepare and has thrown some new things. All 11 guys up here within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage.
They almost jumped offside. And now Heupel to go to work again. Throws wide open man. Threw it behind Woolfolk. That would have been a touchdown. Defensively for Kansas State, here's how they look. Bisel and Robinson. Fatafehi, we've seen make a big play already, and Chris Johnson leads them in sacks. Couple of linebackers. Kazar's back in there after being injured, and Lieber is one of the leaders defensively. They'll play a lot of defensive backs, as you might guess. Butler, McGraw, Cooper, Tyler's the nickel, Carter the corner, and Proctor will play in dime situations.
And they're being very aggressive. None of the soft zone stuff.
Nope. 3 wideouts to the left side for Heupel. He's looking the other way, though, and he's flushed. Throws to Norman, who made a great catch out in front of him, and the big fella gets it down, and he might have a first down at the 14-yard line.
You know, Heupel is so good. He does a lot of good qualities and a lot of nice things, one of which is avoiding him. Watch his feet. He doesn't try and bring the ball down and run. He just slides around, buys some time, and then gets the ball to a receiver.
This one's close enough to look at. Norman is one wicked target because he's 230 pounds on a 6'2 frame, and he used that physicality to get where he got. Now we'll just see about the spot. A little bit short. About a foot short. Josh Heupel. That was the most given up by Kansas State in the air all year. He was near perfect. 78%, 374 and 2, and he ran for one.
And this is not chopped liver they're going against either. Kansas State, second best defense in the nation. They only give up 168 yards through the air on the average.
Heupel already tonight, Bob, and this first quarter looks more like he did in October than he has in the last 3 weeks.
Yeah, and they're giving him some shots. There's some single coverage downfield. They've just had good coverage. Question going in, was there going to be soft zones or were they going to come after him? They've done pretty much what their defensive scheme's been all along.
Third down and a foot.
Look at this. Here they come again.
Heupel changing things up.
There's a linebacker right here. Linebacker's up.
He'll give it to Griffin. He's hitting the backfield again. This time it's Ben Lieber, the defensive captain. Boy, they're coming up with big plays when they need them.
Lieber is a junior, and he's the captain, and he just came in and just stuffed it. This defensive line is very good and very aggressive for Kansas State.
So this time, Bob Stoops says, let's try to take the three. Tim Duncan will come out. Duncan on the year, 11 out of 19. Going to try a 32-yard field goal. Smack in the middle of the field. And our scoreless tie is broken. The Sooners, with great field position still, can only muster a field goal. They wanted more, but they do lead by three. Heupel from the gun. On first down, draw play, going nowhere. Nice job defensively again. Robinson's there, so's Chris Johnson.
I tell you what, I've never, you know, we do games all around the country. This defensive line, they have three defensive linemen that are in the top four on the team in tackles. We don't see that anywhere.
Ever.
We always see defensive linemen just taking up blocks, and then the linebackers and defensive backs come in to make the plays.
And they're in the top 15 in four major categories in the national rankings. You saw three of them there, including number two overall. Second down and 12 after they lost two on the draw play. Heupel pump fakes, wants to go long. Will for Wolfo. It's intercepted. Picked off by Dashad Carter. They went to the well one time too many.
Great coverage by Carter.
They tried that play three or four times already, Bob, and we're still in the first quarter.
Well, they have, and this was just single coverage. You see him do a little pump. Carter never went for the pump, was playing the deep route all the way. Good coverage. That's his fifth interception of the year and his 13th of his career.
That's just beautiful defense. Kansas State now, great opportunity. Their best starting field position, and it's Scobie on a sweep. Scobie got a couple, and at about the 41-yard line, Kalmus knocked him off his pins.
Talking to Ron Hudson yesterday, offensive coordinator for Kansas State, says we've got to get the running game going. That's why they're making such an effort to get it going. We cannot put the game in the hands of Jonathan Beasley. We got to give him some help.
There's Heupel's numbers early. For Josh, that's his 12th interception against 18 touchdown passes. Second down and eight, just outside the OU 40. And it's Cartwright, and he's the guy that's getting the running game going, quite frankly. He's doing a pretty good job of it. So he's going to be about 3 yards shy of a first down. And our first and 10 is presented by Pacific Life, so you see where they have to get with a third down coming up. Our line of gold is at about the 33-yard line. Line of scrimmage is the 36, and we've got 2:20 left first quarter. 3-0 Oklahoma out of Duncan field goal. Lockett in motion. He'll take it on an end around. Lockett with a lead blocker in Scobie, but he didn't get there. Torrance Marshall collared him over there before he got to the stick.
You can tell which team had a week off to prepare, had 2 weeks really, because Kansas State is coming out with some new things, both offensively and defensively. Number 10, Torrance Marshall, sideline to sideline, making the plays,
wow.
Been making them all year long.
And with he and Calmus together, that's something special. 10 and 20. And it's fourth down. And Kansas State's got its offense out there, and it's staying out there. They're kind of in Neverland. They're too far out for a kick. They don't want to waste a punt here at the 35. You don't get many trips here. Fourth down and two. So both teams. Now they're going to try a quick kick.
A little pooch punt.
Not a bad job either by Beasley. It's a beauty. And it's saved at the 3 yard line.
He was practicing that in pregame. Usually the coaches from both sides are looking at the other teams. They always have a coach watching what the other team's doing. Nice job, Jonathan Beasley, little pooch punt.
That's
the advantage. The advantage of not showing the punt is that the other team doesn't put somebody back there to catch it.
Right. They tried to get a timeout call. Torrance Marshall saw it coming. He couldn't get a timeout called in time. And then everybody had to clear the area, and it rolls dead down at the 3 yard line.
That is really good.
That's beautiful. That's good football. So, as Kansas State was earlier, Oklahoma buried in its own end. And Heupel in the end zone from the gun. Josh swings it out to Griffin, who somehow made a shoestring catch and got him a little bit of room to work out near the 9 yard line. Pickup of 6. Terry Pierce made the stop, and we're under a minute in the quarter.
Josh kind of short-armed that one.
Yeah, he did. That was a good catch. Griffin had to take it off his shoe tops. And
like
it's second
down
and 4.
This is not any easy job going up against this defense. And if you were wondering what Kansas State was going to do defensively, were they going to do what the last three defenses did, play soft zones? The answer is no. They are up there. They are pressuring. They are mixing some of their coverage defensively, and here they come.
Boy, they timed that one beautifully. The ball is tipped, and it's in the air, and it's intercepted. The Wildcats have it at the 11-yard line.
I didn't see
Devane Robinson on the deflection, and the defensive lineman's got a dream, and Heupel's thrown 2 interceptions.
Trying to hit the little slant route. The ball got there. The receiver, was it? Who was trying to catch it? Fagan. The ball hits Fagan. He just doesn't keep his eyes on it.
So an Oklahoma native, Devane Robinson, comes up with a huge play from his defensive tackle spot. And now at the 11-yard line, it's Kansas State, first and 10. It again in motion. They fake the end around, and now they go with a tight end, Meyer, and he keeps it around the left end.
The last two plays by Kansas State have been reverses, one to Lockett, one to the tight end, Meyer.
That time they had Lockett come in motion again as though they were going to give it to him, and they give it to Meyer instead, the tight end around the left side, and that's going to expire quarter number 1. Set to start the second quarter, 3-0 Oklahoma. And the Dr. Pepper first quarter statistics, Kansas State with all the rushing yards, OU still in the negative there, and 2 turnovers, 2 interceptions of Heupel, and 1 fumble by Kansas State.
Yeah, we've had 3 turnovers in the first quarter, and that's why coaches always talk about turnovers.
Allen, the tailback now. Here's a little bit of keeper by Beasley, and he weaves his way. He's not fast and he's not fancy, but he seems to have a knack for doing it on the ground. His 17th rushing touchdown of the year.
He likes to call his own number inside the 20-yard line, inside the 15. A lot of touchdowns, as Brad just said, 17 rushing touchdowns.
Jamie Rehm has hit 32 straight extra points. He's hit 33 straight extra points. Kansas State in front, 7-3. They took advantage of the interception.
Well, the defense set up the score. the aggressive pressure defense. Here they are right here. Eight guys right here will come. Three guys out on the outside to cover the three guys. Pressure defense is what Kansas State does best. It's deflected in the air. They're putting not pressure on the Heupel, not giving him much time. Inside the 15, that's a quarterback keep all the way.
Nothing fancy, not very fast, not very shifty, but he knows where the end zone is.
He's just a tough, good football player right here. He doesn't have the passing skills of a Josh Heupel, but he knows how to play the game.
The Wildcats increased their lead to 7 when Jamie Reams successfully converted a 22-yard field goal midway through the second quarter. So with K-State leading 10-3, we now rejoin our action with 5:15 remaining in the first half, and the Wildcats have the ball first down and 10 from their own 26.
And Oklahoma, its first Southern Division title ever, and they're trying to take it and a shot to Miami all in one fell swoop. And so far they're trailing 10-3.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense. It'll be a 5-yard penalty on the remaining first down.
That one on Beasley, I think. Bill Snyder, what a remarkable job he has done at Kansas State. But we said penalties have been a problem.
Yeah, but he's done a great job at Kansas State.
The worst penalty year they ever had was 98. They had 118, but they also were in the championship game that year. Beasley winds up and fires deep. It's almost intercepted by Michael Thompson. Boy, Beasley showed his arm there and went deep for Morgan.
He did. He had him if he would have thrown the ball sooner and gotten the ball there. Both receivers were open downfield.
Lockett was down there with him.
Yeah. He just threw it too late and allowed Thompson time to get back inside. Right now. Throw it now. Now. He can't see. See, he's looking downfield. He's trying to find where the, and he's looking around the offensive and defensive linemen. That's why he didn't throw it when he should have to make the completion.
They list Jonathan at 6'1". We spent a lot of time with him yesterday. I'm not sure about 6'1". Second down and 15. They'll try to go straight ahead. This has worked for him, but not this time, as they've got Cartwright all wrapped up. Roy Williams was one of the first ones there, and he got help from his Sooner friends. .450 left in the half, and a third and long coming up, and our first and 10 presented by Pacific Life, and it's going to be more than 10 this time. They need 12 for a first down. They need 13, in fact. Long yardage situations. Three wide receivers, including Morgan. And when it's third and long or more, they haven't fared too well. Third and 5 and more, I should say. This is 13 yards to go. Play action. Beasley fires on the sideline, almost intercepted. And it was Michael Thompson. He's had his hands on the last two passes.
He has. That's a dangerous situation for Kansas State. They are not a sophisticated passing attack. And Beasley should not be put in difficult situation trying to pick up third and 13. This is a dangerous throw right here.
Oklahoma's defense did its job, and they're going to win the battle of field position here unless it's a monster punt. Travis Brown to kick, and that's JT Thatcher. Brown's inside his own 10.
Thatcher's run two punts back for touchdowns.
Let's see if Savage does a little dancing back there to try to block a kick. They got it! Picked out of the air! Ante Jones has got it for Oklahoma.
Is Norman.
Two starting wide receivers in on the punt block team, and Norman got it. Swanee told us when we opened the show that it could take a play like that, and Bob Stoops is finally smiling.
Where's Norman? Right here. He's going to come right up the center. He's one of the starting wide receivers, one of the top five. His is his second punt block of the year. The other one was blocked by Savage, who is also a wide receiver.
We saw Savage get his. Now we've seen Norman get his. Yeah. And he's out there as a wideout on first and 10, trying to take advantage of the turnover. Heupel in an empty backfield from the shotgun. In trouble. And he got it complete. Mackey. And Mackey's got it down to the 11-yard line.
It's all on the shoulders of Josh Heupel. He's competing with the defense, and the defensive coordinator, Phil Bennett, told us yesterday, he says, I did a bad job the first game in Manhattan. I called some blitzes on third and long situations I should have never called. He says, today I'm going to be smarter. He's still pressuring him, but he's also mixing things up downfield.
Norman and Mackey go out, and Griffin and Luttrell, the backfield, comes back in. Second down, a short four. Under 3:20 in the half. Undefeated Oklahoma trailing by a touchdown, but trying to tie it up here. Savage in motion.
Here they come.
Heupel swings it out to Griffin. Inside the 10, Griffin puts his head down, and he's very close. Out of bounds inside the 2. Just outside the 1-yard line. He almost scored.
I like this call. Blitz inside, swing it outside, and get rid of it quickly. Don't hold the ball back there. The other choice is throw it quickly.
Now, Bob, Brad, this is tough territory for Oklahoma because they don't have that big running back to pound it in. Last time these two teams met, they only had 11 yards total rushing in the ball game. So this creates quite a problem for the Oklahoma offense because it's tough to throw with only the 10 yards of the end zone.
Griffin is the tailback. Luttrell, the fullback, is in motion. They fake it to Griffin. They go to the end zone to the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Trent Smith. For the 24th game in a row, Heupel's thrown a touchdown pass. And we're a point away from a tie ball game.
Turnovers have driven the offenses in this ballgame. Block kick turns into a touchdown.
Duncan for the point after to try to make it even at 10. And he does, right down the middle. Well, Bill Snyder's team had a touchdown lead. But Josh Heupel, as he's done so well all season long, pulled the trigger to the perfect man.
If you're going to throw the ball down on the 1-yard line, the best time to throw it is on first down. Tight end releases. Look how wide open he is. Heupel throws it out. Could have thrown it further to the sideline. Kind of short-armed that one. But Smith goes up and makes the play over Cooper.
And Smith at 6'5", got up over Cooper, number 40. And Bob Stoops, who was smiling after the blocked punt, what was he acting like after the touchdown? He'll take it. Tie game. Earlier, we asked you our Aflac trivia question, in what year did the closest Heisman Trophy vote take place? We gave you time to think of it. Remember of 85, Bo Jackson just over Chuck Long of Iowa in the closest one ever. And Chuck Long, the passing game coordinator here, who has worked with Josh Heupel since his arrival on Bob Stoops' staff. And Heupel, shovel pass, haven't seen it all day. Here's Quentin Griffin. Griffin out to the 37-yard line. And Chuck Long in the old days for Hayden Fry at Iowa. And there's how he looked. And boy, he put up some impressive numbers that only Drew Brees could catch. And he did it this year.
He did. He broke all the records. And
there's Chuck.
Does a nice job helping Josh Heupel. That, you know, that one of the blessings for Josh was to have a guy that's been through it.
The Heisman race.
Not only through college wars, but also the Heisman thing. And Josh has handled it very well.
Bob Stoops says, I finally sat him down last week and I said, you know, you're so cool you never say anything, but I'll ask you, is it bothering you? And he said, no. I'm all right, coach. Don't worry about me. Three wideouts to the top of your screen. They got to hurry. They got the pass away. The screen out to Savage. I don't think he got the first down, but he got very close. Maybe he did. He stretched it out pretty well. Chris Johnson made the tackle from his defensive end spot. Mackey limping off.
The red zone coverage. Heupel does a very nice job of reading coverages.
Ooh, Mackey got rolled up on by his own man.
He did. One of the things we've seen from Oklahoma is that shovel pass. The one thing that we have not seen from Kansas State to Quincy Morgan is the jailbreak screen.
That's right.
The wide receiver screen.
And they run it as well as anybody.
Yes, they do.
So Mackey limping off, but apparently is okay. And it's a first down. So Savage stretched out at the very last and got the inches needed for the first down. Quentin Griffin comes back in, and now Norman will go out. Eight different receivers Heupel's used today. Trying to mount an offensive drive that's time-sustaining and fruitful at the end. It's been tough to come by. Heupel, draw to Griffin. Straight ahead, still going, the little fella. He's got some powerful legs. He got about 5 yards.
Came into the game with nearly 700 yards rushing on the ground and another 38 receptions.
And that was a single season school record for running backs at Oklahoma. Of course, all the years of option football and wishbone football, there weren't a lot of guys catching passes. That's the longest run by the Sooners tonight, and it was 5 yards.
What does that tell you about the defense they're playing against?
I guess. Again, a trio of receivers to Heupel's left. Here comes a blitz. Josh got rid of it. Tight end Trent Smith. He's been the man, and he's got it to the 37-yard line. 17 more yards.
Well,
that's his best game of the year.
There's no question. What they're doing is they're throwing on Jared right here. They're just throwing on Jared Cooper, just going to run a little slant. Everybody else is inside. They've thrown to Smith about 4 or 5 times, and each time Jared Cooper's been on him.
4 times for 47 yards and a touchdown, to be exact. First down, the Sooners. Here's a shovel pass again. Griffin, and a penalty marker down as Fatafehi drags him down. And Swanee, we got a face mask maybe?
Yeah, I'm looking at it as the play came down. It has to be inadvertent. The hand just came right by the face mask and just dropped straight down. Didn't look like he really snapped the head back. So if he's going to call anything, it has to be an inadvertent face mask.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Josh Norman just gave us the preliminary signal as Fatafehi got out there. And right there it is. That's the swan's eye view of it.
Swan's eye. This defensive line with Fatafehi, Beisel, and Johnson, one of the best in the nation.
You put those guys together, you come up with a lot of sacks.
Come
over
up with
30.
You come up with 31 to be exact.
So they walk it down to the 32-yard line, and a first down there. We got Saturday Night Football going on right now. It's 1st and 5, Oklahoma. Quentin Griffin, they fake the end around. He'll keep it. He's got the corner. Griffin, 20. Griffin inside the 10 on his 1st and goal, Oklahoma.
This is a play you're seeing more and more of in college football and in pro football, where they'll run a sweep and fake a reverse. And what this does, you see they fake the reverse to Savage. It stops the backside penetration, the backside flow. They all see that reverse guy coming around, and they have to stay and hold their position just in case he gets the ball.
Scott Kempenick's out there limping around at offensive tackle. He wanted somebody to come in and take his spot. They didn't get anybody in there, so he's going to have to line up on the right side of that Sooner line. 1st and goal, Oklahoma. Try to regain the lead. Heupel waits. Scans the field, finally throws, and nobody home. The closest guy was Ben Lieber, the linebacker.
Yeah. I tell you, Latrell, the fullback, is doing a great job of picking up these linebackers when they get a full head of steam. But handed to the defensive backs downfield, nobody's getting open.
Nobody's open. You know, it was kept pretty quiet about Josh Heupel having a bursal sack in his throwing arm that's been a problem all season long. Greece, could that be bothering him? He's thrown some balls that just don't look like him.
You know, I mean, he's got a lot of pressure put on him. I mean, he's getting hit a lot. But when he throws the ball, some of the time he's getting close to anybody.
Second and goal at the Kansas State 8. Heupel dances around. He might try to get this one on the ground. He heads to the corner. He's in. Touchdown. Heupel from 7 yards. And the Sooners are in front. They give him grief about his speed in the 40, but he's been fast enough this year on some touchdown runs.
In that situation, he was fast enough.
Duncan for the point after, and the number one team in the country is up 7.
What I like about Josh Heupel, if he can't do it through the arm, breaking there, he's got enough sense and ability to get outside and says, all right, I'll beat you with my feet.
And he does to the corner. Sooners lead. Look at the 1987 Iowa football coaches. That handsome gentleman in the corner is Hayden Fry. Bill Snyder is with him, and so is Bob Stoops. Dan McCarney, Iowa State's down there in the left corner. That's a pretty good group. We're going to talk to the old Silver Fox himself, Coach Fry, here in just a second. Heupel from the gun. Flares it out to Griffin. And Griffin dragged down from behind. Nice defensive play by Monty Beisel. Hayden Fry is along with us, and Coach, a lot of guys on both these sidelines are your proteges. You got to be pretty proud of them.
Brad, I couldn't be more happy. I was kind of hoping that the game be called at halftime so neither one of them would lose.
I know when you first contacted Bill Snyder, what was he, a swimming coach down in Sherman, Texas?
Yeah, he was assistant football and the head swimming coach at a little place down in Sherman, Austin College.
Second down and 8 here.
Here they come.
Heupel had it batted in the air. Knocked down by Deron Tyler. Coach, the guys you put together, including Barry Alvarez and all the rest, what did you see in all these guys when you got them all on your staff?
Well, I think that's the secret of me being in football so long. I knew how to surround myself with winners. All these guys were great assistant coaches, and now they're great head coaches. I counted up 26 altogether that are head coaches at either college, high school, or pro ball.
And you know, I tell you, you taught Bill Snyder one of the best things, and that's to never tell the media anything.
Well, I don't know how that happened. Bill was with me only 17 years.
Here's Heupel on a third down and a long 8.
Watch this one right here.
Sets up, it's going to go deep down the sideline. Wolfolk trying to make the adjustment and almost caught it. Nice shot, Carter.
Good throw, good coverage.
And it's time for Oklahoma to punt, so Kansas State's going to get it back.
Top of your screen. Does a nice job of going up for the ball. Carter doesn't see it.
Almost caught it 3 times.
Just can't make the play.
Never caught it at all. And now a dangerous Lockett, who had a 33-yarder call back on that penalty the last time he touched it. Of shifting again on the Kansas State front. Bringing some pressure. They almost got there. And now Lockett on a line drive at the 43.
Look out.
Lockett, he might be gone. He is. Forget it. Lockett will take it. Touchdown, Kansas State. We told you all night long, you can't give him an inch. He'll take a mile. He just took 58 yards. We're a point away from being tied up. And an unhappy Bob Stoops on the sideline.
That's the 4th punt that Kansas State has returned for a touchdown this year. And the 3rd for Lockett.
A very important point after. Here's a guy that never misses extra points. He didn't miss this one either. 17-17.
The main concern on this punt is blocking, then you get a low kick. What Lockett is so good at is making the first wave miss. He made about three or four guys miss without any blocks. And the speed of it, it was a low kick. He caught it right in flow and just kept going.
As a former punt returner, Bob, you watch this young man, the way he performs is just outstanding. He is always moving forward, and you're right. A good punt returner has to always make the first man miss. But Aaron Lockett made the first, second, and third man miss and never once went lateral. He kept moving down the field, and on a short kick where it's just a line drive, the punt coverage team just doesn't have enough time to respond and react to that kind of speed.
You know, we talk so much about the special teams to open up the game tonight. Hayden Fry's along with us, and Coach, you know how important they are, and Bill Snyder talks about them all the time. People forget about them, but they win you a lot of ball games.
Well, they really do, especially when you have two great teams playing great defense. It gets down to the kicking game and the specialty team.
So we got a tie game. And Oklahoma will get it next. We talked about Coach Snyder, Hayden, a little bit. When you got to Iowa and saw Bob Stoops, did you wonder what in the heck they'd recruited that guy for?
No, I never doubted the young man. He was so intelligent. He was a great student of the game as a player, and then as an assistant coach, he did a wonderful job. There wasn't any doubt in my mind that he would become a successful head coach.
Well, I know how proud you are of all these guys that came through your program. Many came through Iowa's players and coached with you along the way. Coach, it's always great to talk to you. I haven't seen you, I guess, since Montgomery, Alabama, where you went in the Blue-Gray Hall of Fame. Say hi to your beautiful wife and enjoy the rest of the game.
You guys are great. It's an honor to be on. I'm proud of those coaches. Thank you.
All right, Hayden.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, Bob.
Hayden Fry.
You know, one of his longtime saying, he brings a smile to your face. I said, Coach, what do you do on offense?
He said, you just scratch where it itches. There you go. I came out of more meetings with jokes to tell at golf tournaments. I never knew anything about what he was going to do.
He was fun.
He's something. Good to hear he's healthy and doing well.
Yeah, that's good.
3:19 left in the third, and we're tied at 17 now. Griffin. And Quentin Griffin got maybe a yard.
Quentin Griffin, the ball carrier.
Tough defense to run against. And Devane Robinson, the guy that intercepted a pass earlier, makes the tackle here. The quarterbacks tonight, always key ingredients, especially when you got one that's in the hunt for the Heisman Trophy. He's throwing 50% right now, which is better than Jonathan Beasley.
Both of them have rushed for a touchdown. Beasley coming in, his completion percentage was about 50% on the year.
Second down and 9 for Heupel and the Sooners.
You got single coverage everywhere.
If he has time, he's going to lay it up for his tight end. He's been his main target, and he's got another one.
Well, that's the game plan right there.
Trent Smith's doing his Keith Jackson imitation. The tight end has been big tonight.
Yeah. They're going to the tight end on Jared Cooper, number 40, the strong safety. Here's the matchup down here. Look at all this field over here that they have to work with. Single coverage, that's the tight end against the strong safety. Right here, 6'5 against 6'1. A strong safety that's used to making tackles, not covering wide receivers.
We talked about it being a great night for him, Greece, and it's a career high night for Smith. 5 for 75. Heupel hit from behind on a play action. He just got leveled by Lieber, and Lieber let up on him a little bit. That could have been uglier.
He did.
Wow, he got hit pretty good, but that could have been a train wreck.
Lieber came unblocked. 52 right here.
And Josh will feel that one for a while.
Now that sometimes, and I don't think that was Josh's man, because sometimes the quarterback's got to be responsible for linebackers and throw hot. But
that was just too free over there.
And he looked away from him.
Second and 20 now. Loss of 10 on the sack. Heupel had it. Almost intercepted, and flags all over the place.
Yeah, and you should. There, he was all over him.
Terry Pierce, the linebacker, was in coverage. He was the one bobbling it. I think he's going to be the guilty party as well. The question, though, is that ball was tipped. I don't think you can call interference back there, and that sure was a knuckleball. That was coming out of there end over end. Hopefully our referee, Randy Crystal, is going to straighten this thing out for us.
Pass interference on the defense. Spot foul. First and 10.
So the ball apparently wasn't tipped. It was just a bad pass, and lucky for Josh Heupel.
Here's a tight end right here. He's just going to run a little in route. That's Anderson, the backup tight end. They're going big to the tight ends tonight. Yeah, he's all over him. That's Cooper, number 40, all over him a little soon.
Oh, boy,
you know,
I don't know.
The ball was deflected, though. The ball was tipped.
And that's what they're saying, it wasn't
yes.
tipped. So they don't have replay, we do.
But it was definitely tipped, and then therefore you cannot have a interference on a tipped ball.
And the Jumbotron showed the crowd, and obviously you've seen our replays from the truck, but the officials don't have that advantage. And so there is a little bit of a gift for the Sooners, or so it appears.
I think Robinson, Devane Robinson, tipped that ball at the line of scrimmage.
Robinson's had a good night getting his hands on it a lot for a defensive lineman. At the 48, first down. Heupel going to flare it out to Griffin in the flats. Quentin puts his head down and gets it down to the 40-yard line. Our place is Arrowhead Stadium. Kansas City, Missouri, the Big 12 championships on the line. Number one, Oklahoma, undefeated. Tied with seventh-ranked Kansas State at 17 apiece. Final 40 seconds of the third quarter.
Heupel looks up and he says, all right, here they come again. I got a lot of single coverage down here.
Including his tight end, but he'll keep it on the ground to Griffin, and it might be enough for a first down. We're going to stop the clock here because they might have to bring out the chain gang again. Mark Mangino, the offensive coordinator for Oklahoma.
He's up for the Frank Broyles Award, which is given to the top assistant in college football.
You know, so much has been made about how defenses have changed things against Oklahoma in the last 3 weeks. And Mark Mangino says, you know, it's almost like baseball.
It's like baseball. We've been seeing a lot of fastballs, and now they're throwing some changeups and some breaking pitches. And after you see these pitchers a couple times, you're ready to get back in the box and hit the breaking pitch and the changeup. And that's what it boils down to.
There's been a couple knuckleballs in there, too, tonight.
I think you're going back to the fastball tonight. They got a lot of pressure defense and a lot of blitzes.
They got a third and one, and they're 0 for 3 on third and ones tonight. Josh taking his time. He ran his team up there.
This is what he's looking at right out here.
And that's his tight end, but he's going to keep it. I don't know. Only needed a yard, but he slipped on takeoff, and they sort of turned him. Monty Beisel turned him sideways. He might not have gotten it. But it'll be awfully close again. They unpile with 18 seconds left in the quarter. They might have to bring the sticks right back out. They should have left them out there.
Yeah.
Dance around them for a play. And they will have to take a look at it again. I still don't think he's got it.
You know, we talk about Bill Snyder and his style. Bob Stoops is almost completely different. Very
yep.
loose, very family-oriented. Bring the kids by practice on Tuesdays.
And he didn't get it. I think he lost a little bit.
Well, he got 18 seconds left in the quarter, so he can just wait.
He's telling the sideline that right now.
Think about it. Yeah, just let the quarter run out.
He's pointing to the clock.
Yeah. They're all aware of it.
So that'll give him plenty of time for an all-important final 15 minutes or more as we're deadlocked at 17. Now the clock does begin. The whole team will come over. We've been out here a long time, but it's one more quarter, the fourth quarter, that's all important. And that's what the Sooners are holding aloft right now. Way to start the fourth quarter. Fourth down and inches. They failed in the first quarter at the goal line in this situation. Option. The pitch.
Whoa.
Griffin's got it and a lot more. Quentin Griffin's got it in. inside the 20.
That was close to disaster.
Was it ever? I thought it was going to go the other way. Chris Johnson almost swiped that ball out of midair.
Watch Johnson, number 36, right there, almost gets it. Hypo just gets it away. Griffith makes a nice play on an option toss not to drop it. Well, that could have been disaster for the Sooners.
Instead, it's a huge play, almost reminiscent of that Texas fourth down play when James Brown come up throwing in a previous Big 12 championship encounter. This one's a pitch play. It's a big gainer. They still don't have any rushing yards, but of course the sack yardage is taken away from that. Hypo to throw. Josh goes to the end zone. Wolfolk, touchdown! He's aimed a lot of them at number 17, and that one went 17 yards for the touchdown.
Well, the key there was no blitz and plenty of time to throw.
Trying to go back in front by seven now. The extra point upcoming. Duncan to kick. High snap. They got it down. He got it through. Heupel now has thrown two touchdowns and run for one.
Well, again, here's Warfolk over here. He's just going to go down and run a post. But the key is only four guys rushing and plenty of time to throw. It takes a little time for him to get out there. Look at Hypo. Look at the time he's got to throw, and now he's breaking to the center of the field.
And Andre Bob did a very nice job. Watch the way he waits and come underneath Josh Norman here, almost like a little screen. Gets a little separation, then gets in the end zone, and he bobbles it just a little bit, but he comes up with it. It just reminds me about when we talked to these coaches. All the coaches on both sides of the ball said they didn't think they could win this ball game without a big play. That's a big play, but keep in mind the fourth down play and the option, that was even bigger in this drive.
The first catch by Wolfolk since the first play from scrimmage for Oklahoma. This one is a touchdown from Heupel, his second. And the Sooners are back in front. Duncan to kick.
That was a big drive right there.
Yes, it was. And he taken at the five by Aaron Lockett. Remember, Lockett had a punt return touchdown, but he's not going to get away on this kick return. Out to the 21-yard line. Josh Heupel's numbers are getting a little better. I don't know if they're Heisman-like.
Hey, this is not an easy defense, I'm going to tell you, boys.
Two touchdowns throwing.
Second best defense in the nation. They come after you. Anybody in the country, Winky, Breeze, they all would have trouble with this defense.
He's thrown two and run for one. He is some kind of competitor. Long way to go, though. 14 minutes plus. And now the Wildcats trying to answer. And they go to their fullback. Heinicke drops Cartwright. We're a minute into the fourth quarter. But the Dr. Pepper statistics through three quarters look like this. Rushing yardage all Kansas State's. But the passing and total yardage now is coming around. Still, both teams, courtesy, as Bob said, a great defense, struggling on third down.
Bottom line, good defense and special teams have both gotten the touchdown.
Beasley now changes things up on a second and nine. Kalmus steps in as though to blitz, but they give it to Scobie. And he's out to about the 28-yard line.
Josh Scobie, the ball carrier.
Thatcher made another tackle, a pickup of six for Scobie. 79,655 have joined us tonight. It's an all-time conference championship record. The previous Big 12 record was in San Antonio, 65,000. And the previous all-time conference championship record was at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta in 99. This crowd is just under 80,000, and they have enjoyed themselves.
Morgan hasn't caught in the pass the wide receiver since the second quarter.
He's out to the top of your screen with Lockett in the slot that way. Beasley, plenty of time, throws to Morgan, broken up. Thompson and Everidge are there. Yeah,
and there were two guys right there. They know, Oklahoma knows who they like to throw to. They want to shut down Quincy Morgan, and on the kicking teams, they want to shut down Aaron Lockett. Top of your screen, starts out and comes back inside. Not a very sophisticated passing attack for Kansas State. Just run out there and I'll throw you the ball.
Travis Brown to punt. Low snap.
Bad kick.
Thatcher, shoestring catch, a gutsy one, and got it to the 48-yard line.
That punter is shell-shocked.
Yes, he is. He had one blocked. He was beaten up on another one and never got an opportunity to kick, and he struggled the rest of the night. Kansas State takes over with great field position. After the short punt, they're almost at midfield. Their own 49, trailing by a touchdown. 6:15 left in the fourth quarter. We say that because this one has all the earmarks of going past four quarters. Gives you that feel. Beasley changes things at the line. And gives it off to Scobie. And Scobie got a little room. Got about five, almost six, before Thatcher and Kalmus brought him down.
Kansas State has rushed for 125 yards tonight. Oklahoma only 47. The Wildcats have had four possessions in the second half and have punted all four times.
Second down and a long four. Just outside the 46. And, boy, the Oklahoma defense isn't giving much up either. And Rocky Kalmus leads the way again.
Well, you look inside, you got Kalmus and Marshall, the two linebackers, number 20. Kalmus just gets in there and gets a piece of it. We talked about how good Kansas State defense is. This Oklahoma defense is ranked ninth in the country and second in pass efficiency defense, so they're pretty good group, too.
A Butkus winner looking on. A possible Butkus winner just made the last tackle. Beasley from the gun. John waits, pumps, look out from behind, down he goes, Ante Jones tracked him down. What a huge play by the nickelback.
There he is right here, he's just going to come on a little short-sided corner blitz. Does a nice job of getting away from the block of Cartwright. And then runs him down. Tries to strip him from it. Big play there. Huge.
Now the punting game that's been so shaky for Kansas State has Jared Bright again set to kick to JT Thatcher.
Got a return on.
Bright off the side of his foot, but again, it'll do the job because it's going to go out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Top-ranked team in the country clinging to a touchdown lead with just over 4 minutes to play in the Big 12 championship at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. There's the numbers on Josh Heupel. Two touchdowns. He's also run for one. Quentin Griffin is trying to sweep the left side. He got a whole bunch of John McGraw.
And he went back to the play that worked very well for him earlier in the ball game. The little sweep with a fake reverse. A lot of times those plays might work once, but they don't work twice against a good defense.
3:40 left. What kind of plays do they call here, Bob? Second down and long.
You're not going to run very well because they've shut that down all day. So you do what you've done all day, and that is you go to your tight end, Trent Smith, against Cooper.
That's worked. Second and nine. That's the matchup.
Right here.
Do deafening sound with Heupel trying to call signals. He's going to try to call a timeout. The referee will give it to him. The snap came just when he had signaled for the timeout. And so he'll walk over and have a chance to talk things over with a coaching staff. Jonathan Beasley has scored on the ground tonight. Has not been particularly effective throwing the ball. Here's Josh Heupel.
All right, man, you got to take it.
And his numbers.
Well, I think what Oklahoma has to do is make some first downs, and they got to do it through the air. And I think they have to do it getting a ball to their tight end, Smith, or throwing it to the back, Griffin.
Smith sure looked attentive in that huddle, and he's trotting all the way out there to the top of the screen. And that's where Cooper will meet him.
Right out here.
And Heupel, hurry, will pull it down and run. He's close to a first down.
But short.
About a football shy.
Hey, Bob and Brad, recall the Nebraska-Oklahoma football game that we did. Oklahoma in control of the ball game, still Nebraska having a chance somewhere in there. It was Josh Heupel not throwing the football, but running the football as he did here, that kind of iced that game.
That's right.
And he's not having the best of throwing days this afternoon, and he might just have to do that. Everyone's going to be locked up on someone. The rush is going to come in. If he can slip through, pick up 5 yards, 8 yards, 9 yards, get the first down, move the sticks, that's going to be the difference in this drive.
You saw Bob Stoops yelling at the officials. He didn't like the way the ball had been respotted. They said something back to him. He held his fingers apart. He said, wait a minute, I'll take every inch, because you already set it down in one spot. Now you backed it up. With a yard to go on third down, they haven't converted tonight. This one could maybe mean the ball game.
They're going to run the clock down and then take a timeout.
Third down and about 2 feet. You heard it all in that huddle. We get this play, we win the game.
Yeah, and that's what they're thinking.
And then Josh Heupel said, you got to take it up a notch. That was to his lineman. He does it himself. First down, Oklahoma.
Big play right there. They've been shutting that play down defensively all day long. And it seems to me like he went on a quicker count, and the defense may not have been ready.
You might have heard Mark Mangino said, go on the quick. This is the quick.
Take it on the quick. He said, if it's there,
right through there.
Yeah, he said, if it's there, take it on the quick.
So the biggest play maybe of Josh Heupel's season may not have been a pass.
Kansas State has 3 timeouts remaining. 2 minutes and 16 seconds.
First down, Oklahoma. Here comes a blitz. He's going to keep it again. Heupel's got some room. Got about 6 more. And now the clock becomes an ally.
You got to start stopping the clock for Kansas State.
Under 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Josh Heupel comes to the sideline again. The undisputed leader of this Oklahoma team. His dad, Ken, looking on. The head coach, Northern State, a Division II school. Not a lot of quarterbacks come out of Aberdeen, South Dakota, but you could tell how much of a coach he is and that he's not going to give into his son an inch. He's been tough on him all the way along. One time, Josh wanted to take the car out late at night. He said he'd be home at midnight. Didn't make it because of a snowstorm. His dad went out, met him, gave him the shovel, and said, you shovel your way until we can get the car back home. So he's been tough on his son.
That's the way to be.
For Josh Heupel, the Heisman Trophy is not what the season's about.
You know, the Heisman Trophy is something, I don't know if they determine it off of one game or an entire season. It's something I'm not even concerned about, or is anyone on this football team. We have an opportunity to go out and win the Big 12 championship. and put ourselves in a position for a national title.
They're a couple of plays away from that. The pitch to Griffin, and Griffin's got a first down, and then some. Oklahoma's got it all the way down to the Kansas State 35.
It's a big play by Josh Heupel. Came to the sideline, and he reassured Mark Mangino, I'll pitch it before anything happens, and I'll make sure it's a good pitch. Let's run the option right there. He got rid of the ball. No shaky toss that time like there was in the first half. The only thing better that Griffin could have done was stayed in bounds.
And the Oranges are flying out of the stands. 29-yard pickup for the little guy, Quentin Griffin.
This is an Oklahoma team that started off the year ranked number 20th in both polls.
They went through the dreaded October string of Texas, Kansas State, and Nebraska, and became the first team to win back-to-back games against number 2 and then number 1 on consecutive weeks. And now for the second time, they're trying to beat a Kansas State team that has been feisty and hung with them all night.
You know, Bob Stoops has done a tremendous turnaround. 2 years there. 2 years there. His record at the school has been like 18-5. He wins this. It's 19-5. You know, it reminds me when I got to the Miami Dolphins, when Don Shula came in 1970. Shula came in and won immediately with somebody else's players, and Stoops has done the same things. He's a very bright, he's very intelligent, he motivates his players. He told them, we're 11-0, but we're burning that. It doesn't mean anything. If we lose this game, we don't have anything. And so they came out well. They practiced well on Tuesday after that, and they came out and decided we're going to make something of this season.
I think emotions have gotten the best of Ken Heupel.
Brad,
what a feeling.
Brad and Bob, you know, when we talked to Coach Snyder, we asked him, was he surprised about Oklahoma's turnaround? And he said if you were to ask him 3 years ago whether Oklahoma could turn around with the right man at the helm, he said, I wouldn't be surprised. Yes, I think it can happen. And he said when Bob Stoops became the head coach at Oklahoma, he said he knew he would get the job done because he knew the quality of coach that he was.
John Heupel, looking at his son, he knows good things are there. Reminds me of a few years ago when I was in the Rose Bowl looking down on my son Brian winning the Rose Bowl game.
Here's an end around for Savage, and Savage gets it to the 30-yard line. Our Chevrolet players of the game tonight. Although Josh Heupel was brilliant, he had some misfires, but his tight end came through. Trent Smith and Aaron Lockett, a punt return touchdown, as well as his wide receiver duties in recognition of their efforts. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
You know what? And I think when I think about that, the wide receivers got all the acclaim coming in. They scratched where it itched.
That's right.
Trent Smith was open.
Heupel keeps it.
Trent Smith was open all night, and that's where they went.
I think Josh ended up out of bounds and didn't want to, and Kansas State saying, stop the clock, stop the clock. And he's talking with the linesman about where he went down or if he went out, and they have stopped the clock with 1:29 left.
The Kansas State is going to get the ball back.
They have a yard in the play.
So Josh Heupel disappointed with the fact that where it was spotted stopped the clock.
There you go.
It's a fourth down and our first and 10 presented by 3Com. It is fourth down and 3.
And you're going against a special team. The only chance that Kansas State's got, or one of the best chances, is to block this field goal.
Oklahoma takes a timeout.
Kansas State has blocked 5 kicks this year.
Duncan from 46. The kick on the way. He got it. It's good.
Hello, Miami.
They took the chance, and from South Dakota to South Beach. Career-long kick for Tim Duncan.
What a gutsy call by Bob Stoops.
I guess so.
In a game that went back and forth with special team blocks and punt returns, knowing that he's had 5 kicks blocked during the year, he sends in his field goal team
And the junior from Clinton, Oklahoma, delivers for his head coach. And Josh Heupel will take it. How about that kick? Oklahoma 27, Kansas State 17. They won by 10 in Manhattan in the regular season. They're up by 10 with 1:25 left. They took over at their own 18-yard line and took 4 minutes off the clock.
What a great drive.
Or rather, 2:39 off the clock. That's what they needed to do. That's what you talked about.
They weren't looking for points, but they got three. They took some time off the clock.
Duncan to kick off now. And he'll squib it. Try to keep it out of the dangerous return man's hands. The only problem with that is they let Jason Kazai, one of the up men, take it all the way to the 40-yard line. 1:19 remaining. I want to thank the folks that helped bring you the ball game. John Corle and Charlie Vanacore, our PAs. Pat McGrath, our statistician. Clint Deans, our spotter. My thanks to Anthony Holman as well. Technical operations managers, Jay Gleason. Our production managers, Michael Heskett. Fred King's our associate director. Our associate producers, Praben Martin. Technical directors, Brad Sheldon. Games directed by Chip Dean and produced by Jay Rothman. A first down with 1:19 left. Time running out on Kansas State. Oklahoma in a prevent back there, and Beasley comes up firing incomplete. The coordinating producer of ABC's College Football is Bob Goodrich. Our director of production, Bob Toms. The executive producer of ABC's College Football is John Filippelli. And the executive producer of ABC Sports is Howard Katz. Rocky Kalmus, still on the Butkus list of finalists. His high school team in Jenks, Oklahoma, won their fifth straight 6A title for Alan Trimble, a guy that's put out a lot of football players for Nebraska and Oklahoma over the years. And now it's the Sooners who might be on their way to a national title, or at least a shot at it. They've got Beasley trapped, but he got rid of it. And pickup of about three is Rock Cartwright's dropped by Roy Williams. That defense is a good one.
It really is, and it's been underrated all year long because of the success of the spread offense, the number of points, and Josh Heupel, the number of points they put up on the board.
Third down at 7. Beasley going to take off with it just to get the first down, and he got more than that. And out to the 42-yard line with the first down. They'll stop the clock to move the chains, but only 38 seconds remain.
It's been a special year for Oklahoma whenever you go undefeated, but one of the reasons is they haven't had any injuries. Not one starter or backup has missed a game because of injury. They've had everybody play every game.
Beasley, deep drop, going deep, got a man out there, great catch. Martez Wesley pulled it down, pick up a 27. 26 seconds left. If they get this thing in the end zone, we're still going to see an onside kick.
That was a great throw by Beasley.
His best of the night.
Yeah, no question. And he went to Wesley, who wasn't so well covered. They've been looking for Morgan all night.
Let's see if they go to the end zone right here. They can ill afford to have it down before the first down marker because they're out of timeouts. Delayed blitz coming from the secondary. Jones almost got him. Incomplete. Went through Derek Strait's hands. Again intended for Wesley.
Should have been intercepted.
Now we're down to 13 seconds. Bob Stoops has been questioned mercilessly about the Oklahoma Sooner Schooner and whether the wheels were set to fall off the wagon the last 3 weeks. And he said, I don't see too many teams out there that are 11-0. There's nobody out there 12-0. They're 13 seconds away from it.
Oklahoma has won 6 national titles. 3 by Wilkinson and 3 by Barry Switzer.
Beasley wants a throwback to the end zone. He's got a man out there, and it's caught by Morgan. Touchdown, Kansas State. It's not over. 6 seconds, all that's left, though.
Morgan just went out and out-jumped the defensive back. He said, just throw it to me. I've been doing that all day. If you just give me the ball.
The biggest problem they've got, Bob, is I don't know even if you can have a successful onside kick. It'll take 6 seconds. I don't think there's much they can do except make this more respectable.
The clock doesn't start until the ball is touched on the kick.
So they'd need a great kick, and then they'd need to put it on the leg of their Rosa Award candidate. So we've got a play or two left.
Rose out to the right and throws back. You're just throwing this up. That ball should not. Morgan just out jumps straight. That's straight number two.
And Quincy Morgan, a big play receiver. There's got to be, and I know from personal experience, a little frustration inside that young man, because you see there, he can go up in the crowd and get the ball. And what he was probably looking for all day long in the midst of all the great coverage by the Oklahoma defense was just a chance to do that, go up and get the ball, but he never had it.
They both have great vertical jumps, but one guy's 3 inches taller, and it showed on that play. And the hands team will come out for Oklahoma with 6 seconds remaining.
Well, you've got an onside kick that the clock doesn't start until it's touched. And then you've got to get a field goal, or you'll have one play if you get it. If Kansas State gets it, then you've got one play. And it won't be in position enough to kick a field goal. No, you'd have to throw the ball down the field.
So unless they try a bit of a line drive instead of a total onside, it's just not going to travel far enough, even if they recover, to give them a crack. They'd have to have one play and try to throw it a mile. So all the receivers are up there within 10 yards of the ball for Oklahoma.
You know, Oklahoma has everybody up within 10 yards. They got nobody back right. If they pop that ball,
they'll go to the left, and Damian Mackey's got it.
That's it.
And that's it. The Sooners survive another one. And Josh Heupel, despite the fact he had some misfires and 3 interceptions, has led his team to its 12th victory of the season in one more snap.
He's a complete quarterback, and he beat him in a lot of different ways.
And now the chance from the Sooners of war number one. And nobody else can make the claim they've got.
Well, they beat all the teams, all the tough teams, all the right teams in the Big 12 during the season. And now they come back and they win the championship game.
The Sooners are going to Miami. Some of the players Bob Stoops coached or recruited at Kansas State, he's congratulating. You saw Fatafei and Heupel embrace, and now Coach Snyder making his way through the traffic as his team put on a gutsy performance and came up just a little bit short. You might have heard Mark Mangino say, "Coach, thank you for everything." That pretty much says it all, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Let's go down to Lynn Swan.
Well, Coach, right behind you. Coach Soup, right behind you. Gotta chase you. 12-0. I guess now you can call this a great season in your Big 12.
It really is, and we really would have been incomplete without it. Everyone knows that, man. We needed to finish the season, and this is part of the season, the way it is. Great job, Jerry.
The score, 24-27. Take us through your thought process. You got down there. You decided to go for the field goal to make
Well, Tim's been a little up and down all year, but he hits a lot of good ones in practices and in games, and I just felt he could make it. He could make it. We were about to go for it, and then I just thought he'd make it. I just had that feeling, and I just had a little bit of intuition, a little bit of good fortune from the good Lord gave me a good insight there.
Well, it's a great season. You're Big 12 champions, but there's a little bit more to go, Coach.
Now there is.
Down at the Orange.
We got a whole month to worry about that.
We'll see you down there.
So the celebration begins. 37th conference championship for the Oklahoma Sooners, and they're one game away from perfection. They'll get a chance in the Orange Bowl for all the marbles.